Welcome to Inertia. Today we will discuss management of Sigatoka leaf spot disease in banana crop. Sigatoka leaf spot disease. Sigatoka disease in banana crop is caused by fungi. There are three types of Sigatoka diseases. Disease caused by Mycosphaerella fijiensis is known as Black Sigatoka. Disease caused by Mycosphaerella musicola is known as Yellow Sigatoka, and that by Mycosphaerella yumusei is known as Septoria leaf spot. It has been studied that the leaf disease causes significant loss in yield. Damage. Severely affected areas is unsuitable for export because of the shortened shelf life. The quality of banana is drastically reduced. Small fingers, premature ripening and peel splitting are associated with the disease. Bunches are harvested from affected orchards, ripens during transit. Symptoms. The earliest visible symptoms of Sigatoka are light green, narrow speck of about 1 mm in length on the upper surface of the older leaf. The infected tissue then turns brown and dies. The extensive defoliation results in delayed flowering, reduction in numbers of hands and fingers. In severe conditions, the whole leaf dries, form the tip. Sigatoka leaf spot. Normally 15 to 18 functional leaves are necessary, but due to Sigatoka leaf spot it is difficult to maintain even 10 leaves. The disease inflicts serious yield losses in almost all the commercial cultivars. Fingers do not fill out properly and often immature remain even after attaining the time of full maturity. Peel splitting and premature ripening are also associated with the disease. Reasons for the high disease severity. Closer spacing 1.25 into 1.25 meters, lack of timely fungicidal sprays, no proper regular field sanitation. Poor drainage, lack of crop rotation, plantation of banana round the year. Mode of spread. Through the movement of plants containing infected leaves, through wind-borne inoculants of the fungus. The diseased leaves are used to wrap banana bunches and packing material. Short distance spread is by wind and water-borne conidia. To get normal yield, there should be minimum 17 to 20 green leaves during vegetative phase 6 months after planting. 12 to 15 green leaves during shooting flowering phase and 7 to 10 leaves at the time of harvest. Preventive measures. Planting of banana strictly in the recommended month, that is June and October. Planting of banana at the recommended spacing 1.8 into 1.8 meters. Apply recommended doses of manures and fertilizers. Spraying of fungicide before the onset of monsoon. Management. Regular field sanitation. Planting of banana strictly in the recommendation month, that is June and October. Suckers should be removed in time. The drainage system should be proper. Water logging will increase the humidity, which favors infection. removals of the infected leaves regularly once in a month started from second month of planting, destroys it by burning outside a field or dump it in manure pit and cover it with soil. Chemical control is the only option. It consists of fungicide and mineral oil combination. Spray of banana plantation with 1% petroleum oil plus half the dose of recommended fungicides at 15 to 20 day interval starting from second month after planting. The number of sprays be increased or decreased depending on the severity of disease and also the climatic condition. Continuous use of same systemic fungicide may cause resistance or tolerance in pathogenic population. To avoid tolerance, alternate spray of systemic and contact fungicides at 7 to 10 days intervals can minimize the risk of development of resistance in pathogens. This content of this video have been extracted from the IPM and INM schedule described by National Horticulture Mission, Ministry of Agriculture, Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, Krishi Bhavan, New Delhi, for the benefit of farmers and extension workers. Please subscribe to Inertia.